Starting a dog breeding business. Step by step how to get money, supplies and equipment. Written by Brian Mahoney. Narrated by Katie Johnson. Chapter 1. Dog breeding overview. Dog breeding. American Dog Breeders Association. The American Dog Breeders Association, Incorporated, was started in September 1909 as a multiple breed association. The residing president, Mr. Guy McCord, was an avid fancier and breeder of the American Pit Bull Terrier and was a close friend of Mr. John P. Colby. Mr. Colby was a mainstay of the ADBA, which prompted the boast of being the home registration office of the Colby dogs. All members, in good standing, could register their dogs and litters with the registration department upon the yearly payment of $2.50 dues fee. It seems that the exclusive members idea gradually was replaced into an open registry to all owners and breeders of purebred dogs. Over time, the association became focused on the registration of the American Pit Bull Terrier. The ADBA passed from the hands of Mr. McCord to Mr. Frank Ferris in 1951. He, along with his wife Florence Colby, the wife of the late John P. Colby, continued to run the ADBA on a limited scale, but with ever-increasing emphasis on the registration of the APBT breed exclusively. In 1973, through the recommendation of Howard Heinzel, Ralph Greenwood and his family purchased the ADBA from Mr. Ferris, whose advancing age prompted his retirement. Mr. Heinzel was a personal friend of Frank Ferris and a staunch supporter of the ADBA, as he registered his dogs exclusively with ADBA. We often wish Frank could have lived to witness the growth of the present association. He would have been pleased. The association continues to grow in the USA and other countries overseas. The American Dog Breeders Association, Incorporated, is the largest registration office of the American Pit Bull Terrier, and now accepting other purebred dogs, usually working breeds. Beginning 27th of October 2006, the registry is opening its stud book to accept other purebred dogs. What is dog breeding? Dog breeding is the practice of mating selected dogs with the intent to maintain or produce specific qualities and characteristics. When dogs reproduce without such human intervention, their offspring's characteristics are determined by natural selection. While dog breeding refers specifically to the artificial selection of dogs, in which dogs are intentionally bred by their owners. A person who intentionally mates dogs to produce puppies is referred to as a dog breeder. Breeding relies on the science of genetics, so the breeder with a knowledge of canine genetics, health, and the intended use for the dog's attempts to breed suitable dogs. History. Three generations of Westies in a village in Fife, Scotland. Humans have maintained populations of useful animals around their places of habitat since prehistoric times. They have intentionally fed dogs, considered useful, while neglecting or killing others, thereby establishing a relationship between humans and certain types of dogs over thousands of years. Over these millennia, domestic dogs have developed into distinct types, or groups, such as livestock guardian dogs, hunting dogs, and sight hounds. Artificial selection in dog breeding has influenced behaviour, shape, and size of dogs for the past 14,000 years. The evolution of dogs from wolves is an example of neoteny, or pyodomorphism, selection, that results in a retention of juvenile physical characteristics. Compared to wolves, many adult dog breeds retain such juvenile characteristics as soft, fuzzy fur, round torsos, large heads and eyes, ears that hang down rather than stand erect, etc. Characteristics which are shared by most juvenile mammals, and therefore generally elicit some degree of protective and nurturing behaviour cross-species from most adult mammals, including humans, who term such characteristics cute or appealing. It has been seen that these traits can even prompt an adult female wolf to act more defensively of dog puppies than of wolf puppies. The example of canine neoteny goes even further, in that the various dog breeds are differently neotenized according to the type of behaviour that was selected. To maintain these distinctions, humans have intentionally mated dogs with certain characteristics to encourage those characteristics in the offspring. Through this process, hundreds of dog breeds have been developed. Initially, the ownership of working and, later, purebred dogs was a privilege of the wealthy. Nowadays, many people can afford to buy a dog. Some breeders chose to breed purebred dogs, while some prefer the birth of a litter of puppies to a dog registry, such as a kennel club, to record it in stud books, such as those kept by the AKC, American Kennel Club. Such registries maintain records of dogs' lineage and are usually affiliated with kennel clubs. Maintaining correct data is important for purebred dog breeding. Access to records allow a breeder to analyse the pedigrees and anticipate traits and behaviours. Requirements for the breeding of registered purebreds vary between breeds, countries, kennel clubs, and registries. It has been concluded that findings imply that when selective breeding was done by humans, it squashed the snouts of certain dog breeds. It also morphed their brains. Scientific American, 2010. Breeders have to abide by the rules of the specific organization to participate in its breed maintenance and development programs. The rules may apply to the health of the dogs, such as joint x-rays, hip certifications, and eye examinations, to working qualities, such as passing a special test or achieving at a trial, to general confirmation, such as evaluation of a dog by a breed expert. However, many registries, particularly those in North America, are not policy agencies that exclude dogs of poor quality or health. Their main function is simply to register puppies born of parents.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.